I've been following your career for quite a while now and just seeing you go from strength to strength.
Things for me really started to change when I started this hashtag Breakini Weekly, and it was about showing real bodies and my body in swim. I think all the mainstream brands, they only ever shoot their swimwear on one size or a 6 or an 8. And I think that it's really important for women out there to see swim on different size bodies, just sort of keep Instagram in a positive place. I couldn't have expected that this would have turned out this way, and it's showing no signs of slowing down. There's been some really big brands that are starting now to book models of my size, and so it's really exciting.
When you first started modeling, what was the industry like?
For me, I think the industry has really changed in the last 12 months. There was a time when I first started when I really had to go overseas to get work. I think a lot of people in the beginning didn't really know what to do with my size. I was a little bit too big for mainstream modeling, and then I was a little bit too small for plus size.
Did you get the whole, you either need to lose weight or put weight on?
Kind of. I mean, I have to say, I have always stayed the same. I have been pretty solid in terms of like, this is my body and this is me, and I just don't want to go down that track. I felt pretty strongly about that.
You are tall, beautiful, and like perfectly in proportion, and it's kind of crazy to me that people wouldn't just go, she's a beautiful girl. It's weird.
It is, and it's so crazy, but this is the way the industry's been for so long that it's really something that I'm trying to change. Is models of my size don't even get considered for those jobs or for those campaigns. They're not even going to the castings, and I feel like only now is that really starting to change, and it should be.
I think it's important to see how things have changed. And
yeah,
I mean, look
exactly.
At your women's health cover.
Yes.
What an amazing achievement. How thrilled were you when you got that?
That has been a dream for a really long time. I've loved women's health. I've always read it. It was a magazine that I grew up reading. Yeah, it was a big goal and a big tick off the list for me when that happened. And to be the first curve model on the cover was really exciting. And I'm so pleased that it was an Australian magazine.
What has been your kind of career highlight?
I think it would be Sea Folly. Sea Folly, you know, a swim and being at the beach and a surf, that's what I'm all about. That's my lifestyle. That is what I've grown up doing. So I think Sea Folly was like always a brand that I wore. I wore those bikinis from when I was, you know, 12, 13. I flew in from New York, and my mum took me to like the Sea Folly store that had the big poster of me in the window, and I still couldn't believe it. It was a real pinch me kind of moment. And to be the first, and so many like firsts for such an iconic Australian brand, it was amazing.